the standard in low-budget podcasting. Welcome to Road Trip After Hours with Mac Davis and WWE Hall of Famer Teddy Long. Holla.
Sportskeeda Wrestling, I'm Mac Davis. With me right now, we're of course at WrestleMania in Los Angeles in Hollywood. So who else should be my guest right now than the original Glow Girl, Hollywood? Hello.
Hi, Mac. How are you?
I'm doing great. Tell me a little bit about how you got into Glow.
Oh boy, long story, but it was an audition here in Hollywood at the Hyatt on Sunset. They needed 12 girls for a pilot. They picked me as one of them. We sold the pilot to Glow, and we did 4 seasons, and I did all the seasons, actually, with the show.
Now, you started at what age?
21.
21 years old, and then you also went into stunt work, too, right?
Afterwards, when that was over, my friend, Cheryl Lightning Russa, said, let's get into some stunts. Now, I wish I would have taken her advice and stuck with it.
Yep.
Because it pays so well, and there's, you know, and there's residuals, blah, blah, blah. But anyway, yeah.
Don't you still do some stunt work, though?
I do. That's interesting that you said that, because 2 weeks ago, there's a Nicole Kidman movie in Nashville, because I'm in Nashville part-time and here, and she has a movie coming out, and I am a stunt driver, actually, on that movie.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Tell me a little bit about the Netflix Glow series. You know, I expected to hopefully see you in that series. What happened?
I know, right?
Yeah.
I wish that they would have had the Glow Girls, somebody to do some cameos, but that just wasn't what didn't happen. So I'm kind of bummed about it. They didn't ask us. I don't know.
It's about time you asked the original Glow Girls.
Yes, but they're done now. Their season is already done, and that's okay, but it would have been really nice to have cameos of some of the ladies. I think it would have given it a little more flavor. Not that it didn't have flavor, because I'm grateful. So grateful, actually, that they did a story about us.
Women's wrestling in general. Is there anybody in particular that you keep an eye on?
I really loved Sasha Banks. So to see her moving around these days is surprising.
Yep.
But maybe there's something more in the works. You know, maybe she's taking a break here and there, and we'll see her again.
And you have soap that you sell.
Oh, bless
your
heart.
Let's talk about that slope.
HollywoodBotanica.com, and that is something that I am passionate about, stuff that doesn't have preservatives in it, and I've always loved that. Before the pandemic, I'm like, I'm just going to start doing my due diligence, getting some books, looking at videos, let's try it. And then I started making it, and it's something that's very soothing. So when I get off the road, going home, some people like to read, some people like to, whatever they like to do, cook, I like to make soap. So HollywoodBotanica.com or NashvilleBotanica.com. I call it both.
You need to find her on Facebook, too, because she does a lot of things on Facebook, including you can watch her actually slice and cut the soap.
I do that. Thank you, Mac. Yeah.
And she also does, you do a lot of aerobic type of work. I see you do planks quite a bit.
Yeah, I do planks, but you know what? That was during the pandemic, so I figured a lot of people are at home, so let's just get up out of our seats and our chairs and do a little exercise. A little bit is better than doing nothing. Even if you do 5 minutes of walking or getting up off your seat to get up while you're watching TV, doing some squats, that's a good thing.
And trust me, when you get a little bit older, you need to keep fluid, because if you don't, you will tighten up and nothing else will work.
And I try to say that to mom and dad all the time. Yep. If you don't use it, you lose it.
Absolutely. Sex bomb, sex bomb. You're a sex bomb. You can give it to me when I need to come along. Sex bomb, sex bomb.